why am I doing this interview? I think a better question would be, why would I not be doing this interview? I'm not African American, but I am Black. And unfortunately, I feel like our voices are only told by, or only heard by literature we read in class or a specific time period they might want to learn about. But all that is potentially taught by a white professor and just a bunch of white analyses that are used as lenses. You know, it's hard for me to learn about myself through white people. Like, I love our professors, but why do I have to learn my history through white men? And so I think that if we're gonna be talking about Black people, it needs to be Black people talking about Black people.
Yes, Marilyn.
I think Blackness is being Black. I don't think Blackness is something you necessarily put on or take off, but I think it just is. And that's okay. And if you decide that's you, then it is what it is. And you can decide just how much you let that define you. Or better yet, if it even matters to you. You know, I couldn't imagine that you could have a Blackness that could be wrong. Like, sometimes I think we're so privileged to be able to say, oh, I'm Blackness or not. For example, I could go work at McKinsey, straighten my hair, and never have to think about Black people again if I chose not to. But that's not me. You know, sometimes I think that we allow others to take our power away, but that's just not the case. And I don't want to be too limiting because people have families and expectations and religions that make it seem like there isn't a choice. But if there's not a choice, then there has to be wiggle room.
I think Blackness is the sin. It's the worst thing in the world, and it's the best thing in the world. I mean, being Black is like the hardest thing in the world, at least in the context of a very white supremacist, anti-Black world. But also, to be Black is the most beautiful thing, and to see what Black people have done in the face of such vicious attacks is so, I mean, just look what these people, what our people, like Marvin Gaye. And I love me some Marvin Gaye. And it's just so crazy to see that Marvin Gaye emerges out of this world that is such a tired and tragic world, yet he emerges saying, we have to give each other love. What other people do that?
There has to be a line that can be blurred or kind of shaken up. Like, when you look back in history, these people, under extraordinary circumstances, were able to wiggle. And that wiggle was enough. And the wiggle, which was the struggle then, was about being able to make your own identity and not having it defined for you by the masses. And you know what? I think that struggle is still really real today. I mean, we're still trying to find ways to define ourselves, and we're still trying to make our own identities. But I think there's also something to be said about patience and just waiting it out. You know, I think about how as I've gotten older or felt like I've gotten slightly more mature or slightly less self-centered or slightly less selfish, that I was really hard on myself for being all of those things just a few years ago. And it's like, if only I could have been friendly with myself and been like, girl, it's okay that you're not leading the charge to end all racial problems in the world right now. There is still growth to happen. There is still growth that can happen. And you know what? I think that when you're friendly with yourself, you're gonna end up liking yourself even more. Because each and every day, you're making steps to become the person you wanna be. But it's also patience with others, who are finding their own paths and doing their own things. So it's patience, not just in the sense of time, but in allowing for space for others to wiggle.